मुनित्रय प्रार्थना येनाक्षर समाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः येन धौता गिरःपुंसां विमलैः शब्दवारिभिः तमश्चाज्ञानजं भिन्नं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् ॐ नमः पाणिनिकाच्यायन पतञ्जलिभ्यः शब्दविद्यासम्प्रदाय प्रवर्तकेभ्यो मुनिभ्यो महद्भ्यो गुरुभ्यः
In this class, we will continue this dat pratyaya vidhanam with tamat agamaha, with the 58th rule, 5 to 58. Sastyadeshcha asankhyadehe. Sastyadeshcha असंख्यादे तस्य पूरणे तमट डटः नित्यम् इति अनुवर्तते तस्य पूरणे डट इति इतपूर्वसूत्रं तमट इति इतपूर्व सूत्रं 57 56 इत्यादय नित्यम् इति 57 सूत्रात् नाउ लेट अस डिवाइड दि सूत्र संधि षष्टि आदेहे दट मीन्स दिस इज द प्रातिपदिकम्स एडजेक्टिव प्रातिपदिकम्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सूत्र शुड बी षष्टि आदि दट मीन्स षष्टि सप्तति अशीति नवति इत्यादि But here we are not supposed to take Eka Sasti Dvisasti because Eka Dvi are added before Sasti. Here they are exempted. Asankhyadehe Ichuktam. Sastyadehe iti first word. Asankhyadehe. Sankhya Shabdaha Purvam Nabhavet. Pratipadikasya iti. So we have to take only Sasti, Saptati, Asiti, etc. And not ekasasti dvisasti. Tebhyaha pratipadikebhyaha anuvartayaha. Tamatagamo bhavati dat pratyayasya puranarde nityam bhavati ichuktam. Why this nityam is told here? This is continuing from the last sutra. Because in 56th sutra, now we are dealing with 58. 56th sutra, it was anyatarasyam, vimshatyadhibhya tamat anyatarasyam, tamat agamaha anyatarasyam vita. So here, from the last sutra, nityam, so that is continuing here. So the vritti is like this, sastyadehe sankhya shabdat asankhyadehe parasya डटः नित्यं तमडागमो भवति सो हियर लेट अस टेक एग्जांपल्स षष्टि वी आर सपोज्ड टू टेक षष्टि सप्तति अशीति एटसेट्रा षष्टि षष्टि तस्मात् पूरणार्थे तमडागमो भवति डट प्रत्ययेन सह डट पूर्वं तमट भवति डट मीन्स अकार तमट मीन्स तम सो तम प्लस अकार तम इट बिकम्स तम सो षष्टितम षष्टि तमट प्लस डट षष्टितम षष्टितम व्हाट डज दिस मीन षष्टितम मीन्स द 60th Unless we count the 60th also, we can't complete 60. That is the meaning of Purana. Now, on Saptati Shabda, Saptatehe Puranarde Tamadagamaha Sahitaha Dat. Saptati Prasu Tama Prasu A. Saptati Tamaha. 70th Ichartha. Asitehe Puranarde. Asiti means 80. Asitehe Puranarde Tamadagama Sahita Dat. Asiti Tama Prasu A. Asiti Tamaha. 80th. Evameva Navati. Navati Tamaha. 90th. Atra Tamadagamaha Nityam Bhavati. Asankhyadehe Ichuktam. That means Sastiyadibhyaha Asankhyadeheva Tamadagamo Bhavati. If Sankhya Adi Shabdaha Bhavati, that means Eka Sasti, Dvisasti, Trisasti, or Eka Saptati, Dvisaptati, Trisaptati, Iti Eva Mabdibhyaha, Vikalpena Bhavati Tamat. So, without Tamat also, only Dat will operate, or Dat will operate along with Tamat. So, Eka Sasti, Tasmat, Dat Prachayaha. So, that is Ikaraha. Ikarasya Yasyati Chaitu Lopaha Bhavati Eka Sashtaha. 61st Ichartha. Tamadagama Vikalpana Vikalpena Bhavati Eka Sashtitamaha. 61st Icheva Artha. Eva Meva Eka Saptati Sankhyadehe Saptati Shabdat Eka Saptaha. Eka Saptati plus Dat. So, Atra Dittuat Kim Bhavati Yasyeti cha iti prathamam takarantaravarti ikarasya lopaha bhavati eka saptat bhavati anantaram ter lopaha bhavati at shabdasya lopaha bhavati. So eka sapt plus dat eka saptaha 71st ichardhaha vikalpena tamat bhavati kila. So tamat sahita dat eka sapt Tati Tamaha iti bhavati. Evam vikalpena tamat prachayo bhavati. Tamat prachayo va along with tamat dat will come or only dat will come. Now let us go to the next sutra. Matau chaha sukta samnoho. Atra matau chaha. Matau means matu iti prachayaha. As a general rule, we have come across this earlier itself. But as a rule, we are going to come across it later only, a little later. So, matupardhakaha prayoge ichardhaha. What is matupardhaka prayogaha? Tadasyasti asmin iti matup. Suppose a particular thing is having another thing in it. Then it is called mat. That is, suppose a particular person has got buddhi. The person who has got buddhi, on buddhi shabda we have to add mat. Buddhi mat. Buddhi mat means the person having buddhi in him. Mati mat, the person having mati in him. So that matvardha matupratyayardha visaye ichartha. Etad matau iti visaye saptami. Chaha pratyayo bhavati sukta samnoho iti abhitheya saptami. What does this mean? When the derived word on the pratipadikam with the pratyaya, the word derived, so if it is relates to a sukta or sama mantra. Sama is one of the Vedas, sama mantra. Sukta means a Veda mantra, any Veda mantra. So when a sukta contains a particular thing, then it is having that matvardha. When a sama mantra contains a particular word, then that contains that word, that matuparchayardha atra bhavati. So atra matuvardha grahanena samardha vibhakti hi bhavati. Etat pratipadikasya visheshanam matuprachayanta pratipadika atichartha. So matuvardheyat prachaya uchyate, that matvardha is there, that means that particular sukti or saman mantra that contains a particular word mentioned, on that particular word that will be the pratipadikam here. So pratipadikat matvardhe chaha prachayo bhavati sukte abhideye, when the derived word denotes a sukti or samani abhideye. So everywhere we will get examples in sukti and also sama mantra. Examples are achhavaka iti shabda. It is contained in a particular sukti. So this sukti is achhavaka shabda mat. It is containing achhavaka. So in the matvardha visaye tadasti. Tadasmin asti ichyarthe matvardhaha. Achhavaka shabdaha tasmin suktav asti. Tasyam suktav asti ichyarthe achhavaka shabdat. Achhavaka iti pratipadikat chaprachayaha. Chasya iya adeshaha. So achhavaka plus iya. Achhavakiyaha suktam. So this particular suktam, Veda mantra, contains a particular word achhavaka. Evam eva mitravaruna shabdaha asmin sukte asti ichyarthe. Asmin sukte asti ichyarthe matvardha prachayardha. Mitravaruna shabdaha asmin sukte asti ityarthe mitravaruna shabdat chaprachaya mitra varuniyam suktam. Suktam is in napumsakalinge asti iti krutva mitra varuniyam ityapi napumsakalinge bhavati. Evam eva samani visayepi, sama mantrasya visayepi yajna yajna shabdaha asmin samani vartate ityarthe yajna yajna shabdaha shabdat chaprachaya yajna yajna plus iya yajna yajniyam sama. Sama also is in napunsaka linga. Yajna yajniyam sama para varavanta shabdaha asmin samani vartate ichyarthe varavanta shabdat chaprachaya varavantiyam sama. So this varavanta, yajna, yajna, mitra, varuna, achhavaka, whatever shabda is contained in that particular suktam or particular sama, that we are imitating that shabda in this prachaya as the pratipadikam here. So because this is anukarana shabdaha swarupam matra pradhanaha. So tatra prachayam utpadayati. Tena aneka padadapi prachayah siddho bhavati. That means we can take two or more words in the suktam and relating to the two or three words, the particular suktam having those two, three words, ichyarthe etat cha prachayah upayoktum shakyate. Example is asya iti ekam padam. Sukte vama iti dvitiyam padam. So these two shabdas are contained in that in arthe ichyarthe asya plus eka plus vama asya and vama asya shabdaha vama shabdaha tasmin asti sukte ichyarthe asya vama plus cha asyama asya vamiyam. Evameva second example kaya iti ekam padam, shubha iti dvitiyam padam. This kaya iti shabdaha and shubha iti shabdaha, tasmin sukte vartate ichyarthe, kaya shubhi, kaya shubha shabdat chaprachayah, kaya shubhiyam suktam. Now, let us go to the next sutra. Adhyaya anuvakayoho luk matau chaha iti anuvartete. This matvardhe chaprachayo bhavati on the pradipadikam, which is contained in a particular sukta and particular anuvaka, is told. But that particular shabda is contained in a adhyaya or anuvaka. Anuvaka is a particular kind of mantra. Adhyaya means samaharaha. Keshanchana mantranam samaharaha adhyayaha iti uchyate. That particular word is contained in that adhyaya or is contained in that anuvaka ityarthe tadapi matvardhe bhavati. So, tasmat chaprachayo bhavati. But when it relates to adhyaya and anuvaka, when the derived word carries the meaning of a adhyaya or anuvaka, then that chaprachayasya luk bhavati iti sutram. Matvardhe utpannasya chasya luk bhavati adhyaya anuvakayoho abhidheyayoho. Matvardheva, same meaning. Kena sutrena matuprachayaha vihitaha ichyarthe chasya matvardhe chaha iti matau chaha sukta samnoho iti purva sutre vihitam. Tadrusya chha prachayasya luk bhavati. Then what is a sutra by which adhyaya and anuvaka on those particular, in those particular two abhidheya meanings chha prachaya vihitaha? There is no specific, let there be a specific sutra indicating chaprachaya in respect of adhyaya and anuvaka, or let there be no sutra at all. The very fact that tasya prachayasya luk bhavati iti uktatvena asmin sutre, tasya luk tasya vithirapi kasyachit vatrate iti asmabhi mantavyam. So adhyaya anuvakayoho, this is contained by Mahabhashya in a very simple sentence. The Mahabhashya says, adhyaya anuvakayoho va luk vaktavyaha. Alternately, that is what is told by Mahabhashya Vakyam. Alternately is not there in this particular sutra, but because uttarottaram gariyasi iti nyayena, Mahabhashya Vakyam stands supreme on Pāṇini Sutra. So we have to take this adhyaya anuvakayoho luk vikalpena bhavati. Let us take examples. Gardhaba anda, gardhabhanda. Gardhabhanda is something which is not possible at all, because a gardhabha as does not lay eggs. It gives rise to babies in delivery. But this gardhabhanda is one word. When a particular thing which is not present at all is referred, it is called gardhabhanda. Gardhabhanda shabdaha asmin asti, asmin ajaye asti ichardhe, gardhabhanda shabdat chaprachaya tasya luk va. So gardhabhanda plus uccha chasya luk gardhabhandaha iti rupam bhavati. Otherwise, if look is not there, garda bhanda plus ucha, garda bhandiyaha adhyayaha or garda bhandaha adhyayaha, both are admissible. Garda bhanda shabdaha asmin anuvake asti charde, garda bhandiyaha with chaprachaya anuvakaha, without chaprachaya garda bhandaha anuvakaha. Evancha, another example, dirgha jeevita shabda, dirgha jeevita shabdaha tasya tasmin ajhayeva anuvakeva vattate icharde, dirgha jeevita shabdat vikalpena chaprachayaha. Chaprasyesya lukva, vikalpena lukva. Dirgha jeevita prasuccha. Dirgha jeevita, dirgha jeevitiyaha ajhayaha. Dirgha jeevitiyaha anuvakaha. Athava, with prachayasu lukku bhavati, dirgha jeevitaha ajhayaha. Dirgha jeevitaha anuvakaha. Evam, another example, palitastambha shabdaha asmin anuvake asti adhava asmin ajhyaye asti iti ardhe palitastambha shabdat chaprachayasya valuk palitastambhiyaha adhava palitastambhaha. Now let us go to the next sutra. Vimuktadibhyo anna matvardhe iti anuvartate adhyaya anuvakayo iti purva sutrat anuvartate. So kasmin adhyaye vimukta shabdaha vartate, vimukta shabdaha tasmin asti icharde matvardhaha. Tasmin matvardhe antrachayo bhavati ichuktam. Vimuktadibhyaha pradipadikebhyaha antrachayo bhavati matvardhe. Tasmin adhyaye vimukta shabdaha vartate adhava tasmin anuvake vimukta shabdaha vartate ichardhe. So udaharanam will be vimukta shabdaha asmin asti icharde, vimukta shabdat anna. So anna, it creates adivruddhi, vaimuktaha ajhayaha or vaimuktaha anuvakaha. Evancha, another example, devasura shabdaha asmin asti, asmin ajhaye asti adhava asmin anuvake asti icharte devasura shabdat antrachaya adivruddhi daivasuraha ajhaya daivasuraha anuvakova. Vimuktadi ganaha atra pathyate vimukta devasura vasumat sattvat upasat dasharkapayas havirdhana mitri somapusan agnavishnu brihaspati ida rakshosura sadasat parisadaka vasu marutvat patnivat mahiyala dasharha vayas patatri soma mahatri hetu. This is the vimuktadiganaha. We are not trying to know the meanings of this shabdas contained in this gana, because they all occur in the Veda mantras. Vedasya ajhayova anuvakeva. So whatever the meanings we tell in the vyavahara bhasha, they may not be relevant in Veda mantras. Some meanings can be told out of these words, but the so-called meanings may not be relevant in the mantra artha. So I am refraining from taking up their meanings.
Now let us go to the next sutra.
Goshadadibhyo unna matvardhe adhyaya anuvakayoho iti anuvartete. Goshada iti shabdaha. Tat shabdaha tasmin adhyaye vartate. Tat shabdaha asmin anuvake vartate icharte. Tabhyam tebhyaha shabdebhyaha un prachyaha. Un means akadeshaha. Goshadadibhyaha pradipadikebhyaha un prachyayo bhavati matvardhe adhyaya anuvakayoho abhitheye. Goshada shabde, goshada shabdaha asmin asti, asmin ajaye asti charde. Goshada shabdat un prachyayaha. Goshada plus aka. Yasyeti chayiti akarasya, goshada dakaranantaravarti akarasya lopaha. Gosad plus aka, gosadakaha iti rupam bhavati. Gosadakaha ajhayaha, gosadakaha anuvakaha. Second example is ishetva shabdaha asmin asti ajhaye ar anuvakeva. Icharthe ishetva shabdat un prachyayaha. Ishetvakaha ajhayaha, ishetvakaha anuvakova. Gosadadi ganaha patyate. Gosada ishetva matarishvan devasyatva devirapaha krishnisya krishnosya kareshtaha daividhiyam rakshohana anjana prabhuta pratuta kushanu. Even though some words can be explained in local vyavahara bhasha also, I am not going to take up the exam meanings, because these are all words contained in the mantras, and the mantra they may carry some other meanings. So let us go to the next sutra. Tatra kushalaha pathaha, 63rd sutra. Tasya kushalaha padaha unnit anuvartate. Tatra kushalaha padaha. Tatra iti saptami. Tasmin icharthe. Kushalaha means nipunaha, samarthaha ichadyarthaha. Padaha. Padaha iti pathin shabdat panchami. Pathin shabdat ichartha. Pathin means marga, or in English we say road, way, this course, they will say. So pathin shabdat pathi saha kushalaha. Pathi iti saptami. Pathi saha kushalaha icharte un prachayo bhavati. So pathi kushalaha iti pathin shabdat un prachayaha. Pathin plus haka. Pathin atra nastadhite iti ter lopaha. Path plus aka, pathakaha. Pathin means panthaha, road, way. Pathakaha means a guide, one who knows the way. Tatra kushalaha icchardha kila. So he knows the way. He can guide others also in that way. Now let us go to the next sutra. Tatra kushalaha akarshadibhyaha kanna. Tatra kushalaha iti anuvartate. Akarshadibhyaha kanna. One is laid down for pathin shabda, but here for akarshadibhyaha, akarsha ichadibhyaha, they are all laukika words. Akarsha means attraction, the thing which attracts also is called akarsha. Akarsadibhyah tatra kushalaha. That means akarshe kushalaha ityarthe kan pratyayo bhavati. Kan means ka. Because kakara will not belong to be dropped here. Lasyak kvatadhite iti sutrat. This is taddita pratyaya. Atra kakaraha appearing at the beginning of the pratyaya, it will not be dropped. So, akarshadibhyaha pradipadikebhyaha saptami samardhebhyaha, that means tatra icharthe, kushalaha ityetasminardhe, kan pratyayo bhavati. Kan is ka. Akarshe kushalaha. Akarsha plus kan, akarshakaha. Atra kanniti kakaradi pratyayaha iti krutva, atra akarsha shabde the anchasya akarasya yasyeti cha iti lopaha na bhavati. Because yasyeti cha iti lopaha, it only relates to bhasanyakasya. Bhasanyaka means yachi bham ichuktam. Yakaradi pratyayaha athava ajadi pratyayaha are called bhasanya. So this yasyeti cha ityadi ter lopaha ityadi sutras, they relate to only bhasanyaka visayas. So this is kan is not, when kan is laid down, the pratipadikam will not get bhasanya. So here akarasya dropping na bhavati. Akarshakaha, akarshakaha, akarshaka, sorry, akarshakaha. Second example is sarau kushalaha, saruhu, takara, sakara, akara, repa, ukara. Sarau kushalaha, saru means the sheath of the sword is called saru. The sword is kept in a particular shield, the upper portion of the sheath is called saru. Sarau kushalaha ichardhe saru shabdat kan. So sarukaha, here also you may note that kan pratyaya, when kan is added, the pratipadika will not get bhasanya because it is not ajadi or it is not yakaradi. So when it doesn't get bhasanya, or gunaha yasyeti cha nastadhite ter lopaha ichyadi te na anuvartayanti atra. So saru will get ka, saru kaha. So akarshadi ganaha pathyate akarsha saru pipasa pichanda ashani ashman vichaya chaya Achaya, Aya, Taya, Naya, Nipada, Gadgada, Dvipa, Harada, Harada, Halada, Shakuni, Ichadaya, iti Akarshadi Ganaha. The meanings are very clear here. Akarsha means the person who attracts or the thing who attracts. Saru is the sheath of the sword. Pipasa, Patumicha, Ashani, thunderbolt, Ashman, stone, Vichaya, Chaya, Samuhardhaha, Naya, Niti, Nipada, Gadgada, Deepa. These are all familiar words. Harada means Saraha, Haradaha, that also means Saraha, Shakuni means bird, Ichari. So, Asmin Gane, Akarsha, Achaya, Halada, Harada, iti ete shabdaha, Ruddha Sanyakaha. Because the first vowel is Ruddhi. Akarsha Majhe Akaraha, Achaya Majhe Akaraha, Halada, Harada Majhepi Akaraha. So, because they are all Ruddha Sanyakas, Ruddhat Chaha iti Chaprachaya has been laid down for Ruddha Shabdas. But here, उत्थात् छः इति छप्राप्ते पूर्वसूत्रेभ्यः अत्र कन् प्रत्ययः विधीयते शेषेभ्यः प्रातिपदिकेभ्यः औत्सर्गिकः अण् प्रत्ययः तद् अपवादत्वेन अत्र कन् विधीयते उन् इति अनुवृत्तं पूर्वसूत्रात् उन् इति प्राप्तौ कन् इति प्रचयान्तकरणस्य प्रयोजनं वाट् इस् दि प्रयोजनं आफ् वै हि हेस् इन्स्टेड् आफ् मेकिङ्ग् उन् इन् द प्लेस् आफ् उन् हि हेस् प्रिस्क्रैब्ड् कन् वाट् इस् द प्रयोजनं आफ् लिविङ्ग् ए डिफरेण्ट् प्रचय दट् इस् आल्सो एक्सामिन्ड् बै दि ग्रमेरियन्स् अण्ड् दि ग्रमेरियन्स् से इति दिस् इस् सरुशब्दः उकारान्तः ओर्गुणः तस्य निवारणार्थम् अत्र कन् प्रत्ययः इस् एसेन्शियल् बिकास् कन् विल् नाट् बि भसंज्ञकं कन् प्रत्ययविहितशब्दः भसंज्ञको न भवति तेन ओर्गुणः इत्यादिसूत्राः न अनुवर्त्यन्ते सो अका अण् इति प्रत्ययोः परः गुणः प्राप्नोति तद् निवारयितुम् अभसंज्ञकस्य कन् विहितः कन् इति ककारादिप्रत्ययः इति भसंज्ञकं न भवति ओर्गुणः इति सूत्रादपि भसंज्ञकस्यैव भवति तत् सूत्रमपि अत्र ओर्गुणः इत्यपि न भवति अन्यत् प्रयोजनमपि यस्येति च इति तस्य निवारणं यस्येति च ओर्गुणः अथवा अनदर् नस्तद्धिते इत्यादीनाम् अत्र अनुवर्तनं न भवति बिकास् कन् इस् कन् प्रत्ययविहितशब्दः भसंज्ञको न भवति नौ लेट् अस् गो टु दि नेक्स्ट् सूत्र 5265 धन हिरण्यात् कामे तत्र कन् इति अनुवर्तेते धन हिरण्यात् देर् आर् टु प्रातिपदिकम्स् लेड् डौन् हियर् धनशब्दः हिरण्यशब्दः ताभ्यां प्रातिपदिकाभ्यां सप्तमीसमर्थात् कन् प्रत्ययो भवति वेन् दि प्रत्ययार्थ ईस् काम काम मीन्स् डिसैर् अभिलाष इच्छा धन हिरण्य दीस् आर् दि प्रातिपदिकास् धन मीन्स् रिचस् हिरण्य मीन्स् गोल्ड् धन हिरण्यशब्दाभ्यां तत्र इति सप्तमीसमर्थाभ्यां कामे इत्येतस्मिन् अर्थे कन् प्रत्ययो भवति सप्तमीसमर्थात् दट् मीन्स् धने हिरण्ये धने कामः द डिज़ैर् इन् रिचस् डिज़ैर् इन् रेस्पेक्ट् आफ् रिचस् इत्यर्थे धनशब्दात् कन् प्रत्ययः यस्येति च इत्यादि विल् नाट् बि फालोड् हियर् धनकः धनकः देवदत्तः इति वदामश्चेत् कः अर्थः बट् पर्टिक्युलर् पर्सन् काल्ड् देवदत्त ईस् वेरि मच् डिसैरस् आफ् अप्टेनिङ्ग् रीचस् हिरण्ये कामः इच्छा ईस् हेविङ्ग् डिसैर् इन् गोल्ड् इत्यर्थे हिरण्यशब्दात् कन् प्रत्ययः हिरण्यकः देवदत्तस्य देवदत्तः हिरण्यकः देवदत्तस्य बिकास् देवदत्तस्य इच्छा वर्तते हिरण्यविषये देवदत्तस्य धनकः देवदत्तस्य इच्छा वर्तते इन् रेस्पेक्ट् आफ् धन नौ लेट् अस् गो टु द नेक्स्ट् सूत्र 566 स्वाङ्गेभ्यः प्रसिते Tatra kan iti anuvartete. Swangebhyaha. The pratipadikas are here. Swang shabdaha. Swanga means prani anga. The limbs of living beings are called swanga. They are the pratipadikas here. Tatra iti saptami samardhabhyam swangebhyaha tatram saptami samardhebhyaha kan pratyayaha kasmin ardhe bhavati prasite iti atra ardhavishayaka saptami. Prasita means utsukaha prasaktaha tatparaha. That means the person who is attached to something or gives much attention to something is called tasmin prasitaha, tasmin prasaktaha, tasmin tatparaha ityarthe. So swanga vachibhyah shabdebhyah tatra iti saptami samardhebhyah prasite ityetasmin ardhe kan pratyayo bhavati. Now we have to take pratipadikas, swangas. Keseshu prasitaha. Kesha means hair. The hair is a anga of the body. Keseshu prasitaha. Icharde kesha shabdat kan pratyayaha. Kesha kaha. What does this mean? Kesha adi rachanayam prasaktaha. He is very much attached to his hair. Always he maintains a good position of his hair. He takes care of his hair, etc. So, atra swangebhyaha iti bahuvachanam svikritam. So, swanga samudayadapi yatha pratyayah bhavati tatha svikritam. Swanga samudaya means you can combine two bodily organs. For example, danta and osta. Danta means teeth, osta means lip. Dantostesu prasitaha. A particular person is very much, he gives very much attention to his teeth and to his lips. So in that meaning, dantosta. So this is a combination of two limbs. Dantosta shabdat prasitaha icharthe kan pratyayaha. Dantoshtakaha. Kesha nakheshu. Kesha and nakha are combined. Kesha means hair, nakha means nails. Kesha nakheshu prasitaha kesha nakakaha. A particular person who gives much attention to his hair and his nails, in the good maintenance of his hair and nails, he takes particular care. Each are they? Kesha nakha kaha. Now let us go to the next sutra. 67. Udarat thagadyune tatra prasite iti anuvartete. Udarat. Udara iti shabdaha. Tasmadeva pratyayo bhavati. Udara means stomach. Udarat thak adyune. Pratyaya is here thak. Thasya ikadeshaha. Udara shabdat ika iti pratyayaha. Udarat thak adyune. Adyuna ityukte adyuna anga purvaka divu avijigi avijigishayam icharte. Generally this div dhatu is dhatu pathe krida vijigisha ichyadi artha are given there, but another div dhatu in dhatu patha is there. That is particularly in the meaning of avijigisha. That means he does not want to win. He has no desire to win over. That means he becomes involved in that. He doesn't want to win over. So, divu avijayisayamiti dhatoho divu prachayat taprachayaha takarasya nakaradeshaha aang purvakaha. So, adyunaha ichukte kaha arthaha avijayisuhu. He doesn't want to win over. So, here, what is the vritti? Udara shabdat saptami samardhat prasite ityetasmin ardhe thak prachayo bhavati adyune iti prachayardha visheshane prasite iti visheshyate adyuna ityetena visheshanena. He is not only attached to it, but he doesn't want to win over. That means, what does this mean? The only by dint of example, we can understand the depth of the meaning of this prachaya. For example, the example is here. Udare udarat thak. Udarat thak means, what is the udare prasitaha icharthe udara shabdat ikadeshaha. So it will be udara shabdat, because this is swanga shabda, swangat prasite kan iti purva sutrat yadu kan, that kan is applied here. So here adyunardhe, adyuna means avijigisuhu ityardhe atra thak prachayo bhavati itarardheshu kan prachayo bhavati. So adyuna iti visheshanardhe prasita shabdat adyuna iti visheshanardhe visheshardhe thak prachayo bhavati tasya ikadeshaha. So udara plus ika adivruddhir bhavati audarikaha adyunaha iti ucchate. What does it mean? Audarikaha means, because it is adyuna is the visheshartha here, udare avijigi suhu ichardhaha. That means, bubhukshaya achyantam pidyate. He cannot resist the hunger ichardhe. One who is intensely hungry, but he cannot resist. He is ajivigisu in respect of winning over hunger. He is not at all capable of winning over his hunger. So he is subdued by his desire for eating. So that particular person is called audarikaha. Adyunaha icharthe, avijigisuhu icharthe, audarikaha iti thak prachayaha. When that adyuna meaning is not there, udare prasitaha icharthe, udare asaktaha, udare prasaktaha, udare tatparaha icharthe, kan prachayeva bhavati swangebhyaha prasite iti sutrat. So when kan is added, udara shabdat, udara plus kan, here adivruddhi ichadi will not be there. Udara kaha and yasyeticha also is not applied here, because kan prachaya is when you add kan prachaya to a particular pratipadikam, that pratipadikam is not basanyakam. So yasyeticha urguna ichadaya atra na anvayanti. So here udara kaha means one who constantly touches or wipes his stomach. In marketplace, sometimes you observe the merchants sitting at the cash box. When they don't have any time, any other work, busy work, then they go on patting their stomach too many times. So One who constantly touches or wipes off the stomach surface is called udarakaha. Udarasya paripidanam karoti icharde. Udara visaye, bubuksha visaye, saha bubuksham jetum na shaknoti icharde audarikaha. Iti shabdaha. Now we will take up another sutra. With that we will end up this lesson. Sasyena parijataha kan pracheyaha. Sasyam, it has got two meanings. Sasyam, dravyavachakatvena, sasyam means a crop. A crop field or the crop, paddy crop, etc., yava crop, etc. That is called sasyam. Sasyam has got another meaning also. Gunavachi shabdaha. Sasyam means a good quality, a meritorious deed, a meritorious quality. Icchadi artha. Tad gunavachi artha. Parijataha ichukte, pari means sarvataha. Jayate iti jataha. Gunaihi sambaddhaha jayate ichardhaha. So parijataha means gunanvitaha ichardhaha. Sasyena parijataha kaha ardhaha. Saha ativa uttama gunanvitaha ichardho. He is full of good qualities. He is a meritorious candidate ichardhaha. So sasyena iti tritiya. Tritiya nirdesha tatra tritiya samartha vibhakti. Sasya shabdat tritiya samartha parijataha ityasmin arthe kan pratyayo bhavati. Sasya plus kan. Sasyakaha. Sasyakaha means possessed of good qualities. Kinchidapi tatra vaigunyam nasti. For example, we say sasyakaha shalihi. Shalihi means rice crop. The rice crop is not having any bad quality, not having any defect. Sasyakaha means sadhuhu, a gentleman with all meritorious qualities. Sasyakaha manihi, akara chuddhaha, purified in the mind, icchardaha. So purification means it doesn't have any defects, icchardaha. Sasyakaha manihi. This money, this diamond is pure in quality, icchardha. So with this we'll come to our refrain. Om sahanavavatu sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu mavidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.